A variety of microorganisms and helminths can attack the nascent moringa if planted in natural tropical soil. The best way to avoid this is to germinate the moringa seeds on filter or kitchen paper in a humid and warm environment before planting the seedlings outside. Only the roots of the now more resistant seedlings, here Moringa stenopetalia, should be put into the soil and carefully covered with earth, leaving the endosperm, which contains all the nutrients for the young seedling, above the ground. The second species now planted is Moringa oleifera. On the 21st of June, 44 days after germination, the young plants are set into their final place. And soon they thrive and prosper.
So our Moringa tree has now grown to about 70 centimeters in height, and it would continue to grow vertically without making many side branches. But since our main aim is to produce as much as possible leaf, we are cutting the tree now, the upper 20 or 15 centimeters, to encourage the tree to grow horizontally, to build more side branches and produce more leaves near to the ground. So here we cut it now. Yes, and the same that we have just done to our Moringa oleifera tree with the small leaves, we are doing now to the second species we have planted here, the Moringa stenopetalia.
Only a few days later, we can see the first side branches appear.
Now it is time for the second cut to grow our Moringa tree even more bushy. We will cut it again about 20 to 30 centimeters from the top, and the leaves we are gaining we will dry, and this will form our first Moringa leaf powder. This is it. And we have another one here. We also cut it here. Today is the 21st of October, 6 months after the seeds of this Moringa tree germinated. During these 6 months, we cut them down to a height of about 1 meter to 60 centimeters to allow the trees to grow more branches. And despite of this cutting down, some of the branches have grown up to 4 meters in height. Now the dry season is approaching. The leaves of the lower branches are turning yellow. And it is time for us to cut the tree the third time. This time again down to about 1 meter. We harvest the green leaves for drying and prepare the tree to produce more branches and more leaves the next season to come.
The leaves must dry completely in a shady place to be properly preserved before being pulverized. As the rainy season with a relative air humidity of over 70% already has arrived, we use an electrical oven for the final drying process.
For the final and gentle drying of the leaves, we use the oven in convection mode and at a temperature of about 40 centigrades and for a time of about 30 minutes. Since we are lacking a small meshed cooking grate, we are using a clean cotton wool fabric to place the leaves on. The door of the oven remains a slit open to allow the humid air to flow out. For the final step of the process, a blender is used to pulverize our dried leaves.